हेलो स्टूडेंट, वेलकम टू दक्षिणा ई क्लासरूम। हम लोग डिस्कस करेंगे असाइनमेंट नंबर 3 ऑफ पीओसी प्रैक्टिकल ऑर्गेनिक केमिस्ट्री। तो इसमें देखिए क्वेश्चन 1 आप राइट, क्वेश्चन 1 में आपसे पूछा गया है दो एल्काइंस दिया गया ए एंड बी हैविंग सेम मॉलिक्यूलर फॉर्मूला C8H14 गिविंग फॉलोइंग रिएक्शन। इन्होंने क्या बताया है ए और बी के बारे में, देखो इन्फॉर्मेशन। ए और बी दोनों को अगर हम लोग हाइड्रोजनेशन के लिए ले जाते हैं, हाइड्रोजन इन द प्रेजेंस ऑफ पैलेटियम, देन आपको देखने को क्या मिलता है, एन ऑक्टेन आप कंसीडर करते हो 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 राइट। दोनों के केस में आपको एन ऑक्टेन मिल रहा है, यानी कि जो चेन है इसी तरीके से चेन रहेगा, चेन में कोई चेंज नहीं रहेगा। ए और बी का जो चेन होगा वो 8 कार्बन का चेन होगा, लीनियर चेन होगा, ठीक है। उसके अलावा क्या इन्फॉर्मेशन आगे देखो आप क्या दे रहा है कि ए को अगर हम लोग ओजोनोलिसिस करा रहे हैं, इन्होंने ऑक्सीडेटिव ओजोनोलिसिस कराया बिकॉज दे हैव नॉट मेंशन जिंक और डाइमिथाइल सल्फाइड। तो अगर जिंक और डाइमिथाइल सल्फाइड दे हैव नॉट मेंशन, वी कैन कंसीडर दिस ऑक्सीडेशन इज ऑक्सीडेटिव ओजोनोलिसिस। नाउ व्हाट दे हैव गिवन, दे हैव गिवन CH3 CH2 CH2OH CH2COH, दिस इज आवर ब्यूटेनोइक एसिड। ब्यूटेनोइक एसिड कैसे फॉर्म किया होगा, ये बात समझा जा सकता है कि दो मोल्स इसके फॉर्म करके आएंगे, यानी कहीं ना कहीं जो हम लोग का जो ट्रिपल बॉन्ड प्रेजेंट है, क्योंकि ये तो आइडिया लग पा रहा है ना कि सबसे पहले अगर आप ड्यू चेक करते हो इस कंपाउंड के लिए, C8H14 के लिए अगर आप ड्यू चेक करते हो तो ड्यू 2 आएगा, दैट रिप्रेजेंट कि जो है कंपाउंड के अंदर दो डबल बॉन्ड प्रेजेंट है, बिकॉज एल्काइन इन्होंने ऑलरेडी मेंशन कर रखा है। अब देखो ए से इसको कन्वर्ट करने के लिए मुझे कोई जो है इसमें एल्काइन ग्रुप रखना पड़ेगा राइट, इसमें हम लोग को रखना पड़ेगा। तो एल्काइन ग्रुप कहां प्लेस कर सकते हो, मतलब ट्रिपल बॉन्ड कहां प्लेस कर सकते हो, एक बार देख लो आप 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, तो आप ऐसे रख दो सच दैट कि आपको ब्यूटेनोइक एसिड एज ए प्रोडक्ट मिल पाए, तो इसको कंसीडर कर सकते हो। जब ये बॉन्ड ब्रेक करोगे तो 2 मोल्स ऑफ ब्यूटेनोइक एसिड फॉर्म कर जाएगा। अच्छा, बी के बारे में क्या इन्फॉर्मेशन इन्होंने दिया हुआ है, तो बी के बारे में बोला है कि बी ऑन द रिएक्शन विथ अमोनिकल सिल्वर नाइट्रेट, यानी कि जो है टॉलेंस रिएजन, टॉलेंस रिएजन के साथ रिएक्शन जब करा रहे हैं तो आपको इन दैट केस ये इस तरीके से प्रेसिपिटेट देखने को मिल रहा है, यानी कि कहीं ना कहीं अगर प्रेसिपिटेट फॉर्म करे 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 ठीक है 7, 8, अगर प्रेसिपिटेट का फॉर्मेशन हो रहा है यानी कि टर्मिनल एल्काइन प्रेजेंट है, सिल्वर कंटेनिंग व्हाइट 50 यानी कि टर्मिनल एल्काइन इज प्रेजेंट, तो दोनों का स्ट्रक्चर बिल्कुल क्रिस्टल क्लियर हो जाना चाहिए। दिस इज आवर स्ट्रक्चर ए एंड दिस इज स्ट्रक्चर बी। हम लोग को पता है इन दैट केस आपको सिल्वर एसिटोनलाइड मिल जाएगा जो कि व्हाइट 50 फॉर्म करके आता है, मीन्स बेसिकली ए जी प्लस इसको रिप्लेस कर देगा हाइड्रोजन को यहाँ से और सिल्वर एसिटोनलाइड फॉर्म कर लेगा, जिसकी वजह से व्हाइट 50 आप ऑब्जर्व कर दो। क्वेश्चन 2 की तरफ बढ़ते हैं। इन क्वेश्चन नंबर 2 they have mentioned कि number of moles of hydrogen gas evolved when one mole of falling compound on the reaction with the sodium। एक बार compound देख लिया जाए, compound देखिए आप, इसमें OH group attach कराया हुआ है, C triple bond CH है, बस आपको पहचानना क्या है कि इसमें active hydrogen कितने present है, ठीक है। active hydrogen अगर idea हो, हम लोग पहले भी discussion में रखे थे कि active hydrogen, hydrogen attached to oxygen हो गया, नाइट्रोजन हो गया, सल्फर हो गया, हैलोजन्स हो गया और कार्बन sp हो गया, एटलीस्ट ये चीजें याद रहे। उसके अलावा और भी हम लोग जब स्पेशल केसेस देखेंगे एसिडिक हाइड्रोजन का तो वहां पे डिस्कशन का पार्ट रहेगा, बट एटलीस्ट ये आइडिया तो अभी लगना चाहिए कि ऑक्सीजन, नाइट्रोजन, सल्फर या हैलोजन या कार्बन sp इलेक्ट्रोनेगेटिव एटम के साथ अटैच एटम को हम लोग एसिडिक हाइड्रोजन में कंसीडर करेंगे। अब इसकी प्रॉपर्टी क्या होती है कि जब आप इसको सोडियम मेटल या लिथियम मेटल, कोई भी अल्कली मेटल के साथ ट्रीट करो, तो इन दैट केस वहां से हाइड्रोजन गैस को रिप्लेस कर देता है राइट, जैसे कि रिएक्शन में हम लोग ऑब्जर्व करते हैं। तो अगर सोडियम के साथ ट्रीट किया जाए, देख लो 1, 2, 3, 4 हाइड्रोजन एटम है, इन्होंने पूछा है कि जो है कितने H2 मॉलिक्यूल जनरेट होंगे, तो अगर 4 है तो ऑब्वियसली 2H2 जनरेट होंगे रिएक्शन के बाद, तो 2 अगर 1 मोल इसको कंसीडर किया जाए, हाउ मेनी मोल्स ऑफ H2 इज गोइंग टू जो है जनरेट, दैट इज गोइंग टू बी 2 मोल्स। तो ये हम लोग से क्वेश्चन भी पूछा है और इस केस में आपका आंसर हो जाएगा 2 ठीक है। नेक्स्ट वी आर प्रोसीडिंग फॉर क्वेश्चन नंबर 3। क्या दिया हुआ है इन्होंने क्वेश्चन नंबर 3 में, अ मॉलिक्यूलर फार्मूला C4H6 दे हैव गिवन C4H6। अब इसके बारे में प्रॉपर्टीज क्या दिया है एक बार देखना, C4H6 have two position isomers A and B. Both A and B are decolorize the bromine water. यानी कि there should be a double bond or triple bond may be present. B release hydrogen gas with the sodium metal. राइट, ये तभी पॉसिबल है जब इस केस में कि आपको एसिडिक हाइड्रोजन प्रेजेंट हो। और हम लोग को पता है कि हाइड्रोकार्बन जब है, हाइड्रोकार्बन में एसिडिक हाइड्रोजन एक ही कंपाउंड को ब्लेजिंग है, दैट इज आवर sp हाइब्रिडाइज्ड कार्बन एटम, तो वो रहना जरूरी है। तभी हम लोग जो है उसके साथ हाइड्रोजन जो अटैच होगा उसको हम लोग एसिडिक हाइड्रोजन की कैटेगरी में रख सकते हैं। तो यानी कि यहाँ पे ये तो आइडिया लग जा रहा है कि दिस मॉलिक्यूल इज कॉन्टेंट बी, एटलीस्ट बी कॉन्टेंट द 111। नाउ releases hydrogen gas with sodium metal, but isomers it does not release hydrogen gas. Write the IPAC nomenclature of name of the ANP. आपको जो है देखना इस केस में, तो फोर मेंबर कार्बन एटम में ये आइडिया अपने को लग सकता है ना फोर के केस में कि यहाँ पे ट्रिपल बॉन्ड प्रेजेंट होगा, तभी तो हम लोग को एक्टिव एसिडिक हाइड्रोजन से हाइड्रोजन गैस रिलीज हो रहा है ऑन द रिएक्शन विद द सोडियम मेटल एंड दिस गिव ब्रोमीन वाटर टेस्ट। तो यानी कि दोनों अब हमारे लिए करेक्ट हो जा रहा है। अब इस केस में क्या है, दूसरा जो है हम लोग को नहीं रिएक्शन में दे रहा है हाइड्रोजन गैस, तो इन दैट केस वी कैन कंसिडर दिस इज आवर एल्काइन, नॉट टर्मिनल एल्काइन। तो दिस टू आर स्ट्रक्चर, बी के बारे में इन्फॉर्मेशन दिया है कि दिस रिलीज हाइड्रोजन गैस ऑन द रिएक्शन विद द सोडियम मेटल, वेयर एज ए इज नॉट गोइंग टू रिलीज हाइड्रोजन गैस ऑन द रिएक्शन विद द sodium metal. So we can consider structure A is this one and the structure B is this one. Correct na? We can go for the question number 4. Question number 4, what they have mentioned, write the suitable reagent to distinguish the following compound. Hamare samne compound kya diya hua hai? One is alcohol. You have to understand that this is a alcohol because the OH group is not directly attached to the aromatic ring. If it is directly attached to the aromatic ring, the property will be completely different. Either it's physical property या chemical property. Now consider these two structure. How we can distinguish these two structure? Any idea how we can distinguish these two structure? Basically, if you want to distinguish, we can use either ferric chloride, or Lucas reagent. Anything we can do. Because in the ferric chloride test, what you will observe? You will observe that this is going to give a violet color. Complex violet coloration will form, and for the Lucas reagent, if you are taking in that case, what we are going to observe, this is going to give white turbidity, whereas this molecule is not going to give any turbidity with Lucas reagent. Now, if you are considering these cases, we can choose any of this reagent to distinguish these two compounds. Now, we have third one, that is anisole molecule OCS3. How we can distinguish this from this one? You can use sodium metal. That will be sodium metal test, and what you will observe that this is not going to give positive test with the sodium metal, whereas other these two is going to give a sodium metal test because they will release hydrogen due to presence of this acidic hydrogen in the molecule. This is not going to generate any hydrogen gas in the reaction. We can detect this is going to be our not alcohol or phenol, in that case sodium metal, that is going to be the ether. We can use sodium metal for the distinguish this compound from these two, right? So separately we are considering this one also, and separately this one. Now go for the question number 5. What they have mentioned, the compound X, they have shared some information about this one. On the neutral ferric chloride, what we are observing, that it is going to give a positive test. The only idea will come in the mind that if it is going to give positive neutral ferric chloride test, so that in that case the corresponding phenol will be there, phenolic compound will be there, or phenol will be there. Because positive test means if you are considering phenol, you will observe violet color. But if you are going for the other phenolic compound like naphthol, that in that case we are going to observe yellow color or something different color in that scenario. That will depend on the corresponding X, means that is going to be any of phenolic compound. The neutral ferric chloride is giving positive test, means there is the positive presence of the phenolic group. So these two are different function. We have already mentioned this different time. We have mentioned this one. Next, they have mentioned with sodium metal, what we are observing, that this is the positive test. Correct now. Now the Lucas reagent test, as obvious, this is going to give a negative test because this is not alcohol, and if it is not alcohol, it is not going to give positive test with the Lucas reagent. So basically what you will observe for the X for they have given molecular formula, that is C6H6O. They have given molecular formula, this one. If this is the molecular formula they have given, we can directly go for this structure, that is our phenol compound. Here this will be structure in that case. Next we can move for the question number 6. Just see what they have mentioned in the question number 6. The distinguish between 1-propanol and टू मिथाइल प्रोपेनॉल द सुटेबल रिएजेंट। इसके लिए तो आना, अगर स्ट्रक्चर अगर आपको आ रहा है तो आप डायरेक्टली जा सकते हो कि व्हाट इज गोइंग टू बी आवर आंसर, टू मिथाइल प्रोपेनॉल, राइट। यू कैन कंसीडर दिस इज 1 डिग्री अल्कोहल एंड दिस इज 3 डिग्री टर्शियरी अल्कोहल, एंड वी नो दैट टर्शियरी अल्कोहल विल गिव इंस्टेंट टर्बिडिटी विद द लुकास रिएजेंट, वेयर इज प्राइमरी अल्कोहल इज नॉट गोइंग टू गिव टर्बिडिटी। तो वी कैन यूज द लुकास रिएजेंट टू डिस्टिंग्विश दिस टू कंपाउंड 3 डिग्री अल्कोहल एंड 1 डिग्री अल्कोहल इन दैट केस, करेक्ट ना। यू कैन गो फॉर द लुकास रिएजेंट दैट इज आवर जिंक क्लोराइड एंड हाइड्रस जिंक क्लोराइड अलॉन्ग विथ HCl. HCl is going to play his role and it will convert the corresponding alcohol to alkyl halide. Because of that, we are going to observe the white turbidity in the solution. Because the alkyl chloride is not completely soluble in the water, partially soluble, and because of that partially soluble, what we are going to observe the white turbidity. And this compound is basically going to dissolve in the water. Hydrogen bonding or something will be responsible for the factor that is it is going to dissolve. But once it will convert to alkyl halide, this will give a white turbidity with that solution. So that is responsible factor. 3 degree will give instant turbidity, whereas the 1 degree is not going to give turbidity. And because of that result, we are going to distinguish these two compounds, 3 degree alcohol and 1 degree alcohol apart. Okay? Now we can go for the question number 7. We can go for this one, Lucas reagent. This is also interesting case. Now, a structure we have to just observe. What they have mentioned? They have mentioned when 1 mole of given compound reacts with sodium metal, right? Once when sodium metal will come, just the things should come in your mind that should be acidic hydrogen. Acidic hydrogen should be present, COOH, and now this group is there. What they have asked? How many moles of S2 gas will release when 1 mole of this compound is going to react with the sodium metal? Clearly, we can see if we will search for the acidic hydrogen, only one acidic hydrogen is present. Now, if I am talking about how many moles of hydrogen gas is released, clearly we can observe this is going to give half mole of hydrogen gas on the reaction with the sodium metal. Correct? Now, what we are going to observe, half means 0.5 moles of hydrogen will release. Which option will be correct then? We can go for the option D in this case for the question number 7. Moving to next question, that is question number 8. What they have given? They have given some compound C4S6. The molecular formula C4S6 compound X they have named. What is the different test given by this compound? The bromine water test, if you are going for bromine water test, this is going to give a positive test. Now, in the Bayer's reagent, if you are taking Bayer's reagent, also it is going to give positive test. Now, the sodium metal test we are observing, this is the positive test. Once there is sodium metal test for the hydrocarbon case, we can directly go for the terminal alkyne. Once they have given sodium metal is giving a positive test with the alkyne, we can directly go for the terminal alkyne. Means there should be a terminal alkyne, and based on that we can discard the option A and option B in that case. C and D is the possibilities is there. Just check. Now the due for this compound, once we will check the due, what we are going to, that D is anyhow not going to be the answer, no? Because if you will count the number of carbon atom, in that case that is going to 5. But in the C, the number of carbon atom is 4. Now if you want to check the due, we can check. 4 into 2, 8 plus 2, 10, 10 minus 6 divided by 2, that will give how much? 2. The 2 will be due for this compound. Clearly you can see in the D option, the due is also 3. So clearly we can discard the option D also. We are going for the option C, CH3, CH2, C triple bond CH, right? So this is going to give positive test with bromine water because this contains triple bond. This is going to give positive test with the Bayer's reagent because this contains triple bond. And this is going to give positive test with sodium metal because of presence of this acidic hydrogen. And all this test is going to give by this all three reagent. And we can go for this option for the question number 8. Now question number 9. What they have mentioned, once again, the same case is there. The molecular formula of the compound is C6H10. What they have mentioned, if you are going for bromine water test, this is positive. Means there is the presence of carbon double bond or carbon triple bond. And these possibilities will be there. Now on the ozonolysis, what we are going to observe, because there have not mentioned zinc or dimethyl sulfide, we can directly go for the oxidative ozonolysis. But they have given product that also signifies that this
corresponding ozonolysis is oxidative ozonolysis. Now if you consider the molecule, there they are given CH3, CH2, COH. Right? CH3, CH2, COH. What is basic idea behind that? If you are going to join these two, how we are going to combine? Just join these two compounds. Because the molecular formula for this 1, 2, 3, only one compound you have got, one type of compound you have got. So basically, on the ozonolysis, oxidative ozonolysis, what we are going to observe basically, these two moles of propanoic acid. So what we can join these two compounds, CH3, CH2. Now C triple bond will be there or double bond. Just check once, deuce you can check, you can consider that one. Due for this compound is 6 into 2, 12 plus 2, 14. 14 minus 10 divided by 2, that will give due is equal to 2. For this compound, due is equal to 2, it will give bromine water test and on the ozonolysis, oxidative ozonolysis, first these two bond will break and after that we are going to observe OH-OH will grow, going to attach with this carbon and we will observe the propanoic acid in this case. So we can go for the, which option is there, any option is there? Yes, we can go for the option A. Option A, that alkyne they have given. Question number 10 we can go. Question number 10. So basically what they have mentioned, ammonical AgNO3 gives a white precipitate after reaction with any compound, then this reflect the presence of. Agar maan lo aap jo hai stolens reagent ke saath treat karte ho ammonical silver nitrate, to what will you will observe basically, that will terminal alkyne, because that will form a silver acetanilide. Silver acetanilide have the white color, precipitate will form. For the tolerance reagent test, we are going to consider aldehyde also. In aldehyde also, this is going to give positive test. But there, we either observe black precipitate or the silver mirror we are going to observe in the case of the aldehyde. But for the case of terminal alkyne, we are going to observe the Y50. We don't have to think here much. This, the answer will be the terminal alkyne for the question number 10. In that case, next question number 11, just check once what they have mentioned. They have mentioned of what, which will give a reaction with the ammonical silver nitrate. Once again, same kahani hai. Kya hai B mein? Ki react with the ammonical silver nitrate means, once again, that only compound should click when they have mentioned ammonical silver nitrate apart from the aldehyde, that is terminal alkyne. Terminal alkyne will give white precipitate, and here clearly we can see the option B. In the option B, the only terminal alkyne is mentioned in the option B. That means option B is correct. Right? We can go for that. Question number 12 also we can do. Similar way. Not much effort is needed. They have mentioned which of the following compound will give red precipitate with the cuprous, ammonical cuprous fluoride. Once again, the answer will be terminal alkyne we have to go. And clearly they have mentioned in the option B, the terminal alkyne is CH3, CH2, C triple bond. Is any other cases is there where terminal alkyne have mentioned? No. So we can go for directly option B in this case. Right? Now, moving to next question, that is question number 30. The question number 30, what they have mentioned, which of the identify the hydrocarbon having molecular formula C5S10 which give white precipitate. Once again, the same story is there. We have to go for the terminal alkyne, and if you will observe, there is two terminal alkyne. One is that in the A and C, both have the terminal alkyne, but we have to check for D. Then we have to go for which have the same molecular formula. Now 5 into 2, 10 plus 2, 12, 12 minus 6 divided by 6, that D is equal to 3. If they have given chain, possibly there should be a 3 double bond or 3 pi bond. So in that case, A and C, if you are considering option A, because this D of the option A will be 3, we can go for directly option A. Because these two criteria should fulfill that compound. One is D should be 3, and another is that should be terminal alkyne. And clearly we can observe that in option A, that is terminal alkyne, along with the D of the compound will be 3. Now go for the question number 14. In the question number 14, the group reagent for the test of alcohol, we don't have to mention that one, that is kind test or ceric ammonium nitrate test. Ceric ammonium nitrate test. Ceric ammonium nitrate. Correct? Na? Ceric ammonium nitrate. Now move for the question number 15. In the question number 15, what they have mentioned? A compound that is C5S12O
on the sodium metal, this is going to give positive test, means there is a presence of
acidic hydrogen.
Whereas on the Lucas reagent, that is going to give instant stability. What that means? That is going to be our 3 degree alcohol. If you are going to get instant turbidity, the only things that should click on your mind, that is 3 degree alcohol. Now if you go for the option directly, you can observe in option B, that is only 3 degree alcohol in that case. So we can go for directly option B.
None of them have 3 degree alcohol. Apart from B, there is no option where the 3 degree alcohol they have mentioned. So we can go for the option B one. Okay?
Question number 16, what they have mentioned? A compound P having same molecule of C5H6.
So what they have mentioned? They have mentioned on the C5H8, I think they have mentioned.
This is C5H8.
Because only then we have with the D of the compound will be 2. The C5H8, these two reactions they have mentioned. One is that on the reaction
with the cuprous chloride, ammonical cuprous chloride, we are observing the red precipitate. What this signifies? This signifies the compound have the terminal alkyne. And another, on the other hand, on the ozonolysis, what we are going to observe basically, that is 2-methylpropanoic acid. If you are going to draw 2-methyl, this is propanoic acid, correct? No? 1, 2, 3, this is the basically 2-methylpropanoic acid. Apart from that, you will get the compound B. Now, come to this part. If that one, what we are going to observe, already this have the 4 carbonate. One carbon will be present here, that one possibility is there. And apart from that, they have mentioned that it is going to give a red precipitate. So we can directly go for the structure, that will be C triple bond CH. Is this compound is satisfying all the criteria of this molecule, C5H8, the due for this compound will be 2, clearly this compound have due 2. On the ozonolysis, it is going to give 2-methylpropanoic acid. Apart from that, it is going to react with the ammonical cuprous chloride and it will form the red precipitate because there is the presence of terminal alkyne. So in that case, what will be going to be our answer? Clearly, we can go for the option B. Correct, na? Question number 17 mein dekhiye aap. Compound A gives a red precipitate with the tollense reagent. Phir kahani same hai aapki. Tollense reagent ke saath precipitate de raha hai. And hydrogen gas is evolved on the addition of lithium metal. If lithium metal, on the reaction with the lithium metal, what we are going to observe? Clearly see, white precipitate means there should be a terminal alkyne. Apart from that, it is going to react with the lithium metal. So basically that should contain acidic hydrogen. The only option I can see for the question number 70, which contain the terminal alkyne, is B. Is option B. And because of this, it is going to react with the sodium metal and it will generate hydrogen. And apart from that, it is going to react with the tollense reagent and it will give white precipitate. Now we can move for the next question. The question number 18. In the question number 18, what they have mentioned? How many of the following compound will decolorize bromine water solution? The question number 18, mein aapko consider karna, which is going to decolorize bromine water, that brown color of bromine will get disappear. So we can go for one by one option. First they have mentioned benzene. Is benzene is going to give test in? We already know benzene is not going to react with the bromine water. And if it is not going to react with the bromine water, we are not going to observe any change in the color of the bromine. So yani ki we cannot going to select this option. Next they have given phenol. How phenol will basically react? Phenol will give white precipitate with the bromine water. This is not going to react as a classical alkene reaction, like classical reaction, but it is going to react something different that we will read in the electrophilic substitution reaction. For the aromatic compound, we will read there how the tribromoyl product will form with white precipitate of this compound. Next, in the third option, what they have mentioned? They have mentioned a triple bond of the compound. So clearly, if the compound have unsaturation, means carbon-carbon double bond or carbon-carbon triple bond, it is going to give a positive bromine water test. And in the next, they have mentioned this compound, alcohol. Alcohol is not going to give positive bromine water test. Next is ammonia, aniline. So in aniline, is the reaction will be just similar to the phenol. Here also, we will observe the
white precipitate, right? So this is also correct. Now, in the next question, that is cyclohexane. So basically, this is the chair form of cyclohexane. We'll learn there what is the cyclohexane. So this is cyclohexane, and this is not going to positive test. This is not going to give positive. This three they have mentioned. Once again, next, if we will go for the next, this also contain double bond, and if it is contain double bond, it is also going to give positive test. This is ethyne, and because of this double bond, it is going to give positive test. Okay, this also we can consider. Similarly, we can consider this option also, because it contain double bond, and if it contain double bond, we can go for the positive test. So option will be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 of the compound is going to give positive test. Now moving to next question, that is question number 19 and last question of this section. The how many number of active hydrogen are present in the compound? The molar mass of that compound is 90 and 0.5 mole of which when treated with the sodium metal dibrate. So we are going to consider first to how many moles of hydrogen gas has been released. So they have mentioned 112 ml of hydrogen is released. At STP, what we are going to consider, we can clearly consider that will be 1 by 2 into 10 to the power minus 2. And if you are going to consider this one, this will be 5 into 10 to the power minus 3. This is the number of moles of hydrogen has been released from the reaction. Now, if you are considering 0.45 mole of hydrogen compound, in that case, what we are going to consider, we are going to consider number of moles of compound. Now, if you consider there is X number of hydrogen atom are present. If X atom is present, what we are going to consider this X. Okay, X atom is present. Now they have mentioned number of moles of hydrogen. That will be 5 into 10 to the power minus 3. This will be, we have to multiply with this. टू के उससे क्यों मल्टीप्लाई करें इस बात को समझना, क्योंकि ये तो हम लोगों ने हाइड्रोजन गैस का निकाला है, हाइड्रोजन गैस का नंबर ऑफ मोल्स निकाला है। अगर हाइड्रोजन गैस के नंबर, एक हाइड्रोजन में कितने एटम होंगे, दो होंगे, तो टू से मल्टीप्लाई कर दो, सिंपली आ जाएगा। तो इसको हम लोगों ने जो है इस तरीके से कर दिया, एक्स की वैल्यू सिंपली आ जाएगा टू। सॉल्व कर सकते हो, सॉल्व किया जा सकता है, बहुत सिंपल है। ये 0.9 हो जाएगा डिवाइड बाई 0.45, दैट विल गिव टू। द टू विल बी नंबर ऑफ हाइड्रोजन एटम विच आर प्रेजेंट, एक्टिव हाइड्रोजन आइटम विच आर प्रेजेंट इन द गिवन कंपाउंड। ठीक है, तो दिस इज आवर असाइनमेंट नंबर 3 ऑफ द स्ट्रक्चरल आइडेंटिफिकेशन एंड द POC। ठीक है, तो आप प्रैक्टिस करते रहो, सफिशियंट प्रैक्टिस है, इसमें बहुत ज्यादा टाइम टेकिंग नहीं होता है। जब आप जेई मेंस के प्रॉब्लम करते हो या जेई एडवांस के प्रॉब्लम, तो डायरेक्टली इसमें टिक, जेई मेंस के लिए खासकर, वहां पे डायरेक्टली आपको ऐसे प्रॉब्लम दे देगा कि विच इज नॉट गोइंग टू गिव अ लुकास रिएजेंट, विच इज लुकास रिएजेंट टेस्ट, या विच इज नॉट गोइंग टू गिव टर्बिडिटी, इंस्टेंट टर्बिडिटी। तो ऐसे क्वेश्चन फ्रिक्वेंटली NTA पूछ देता है कि हाउ मेनी, जैसे यहाँ पे क्वेश्चन पूछा, ऐसे क्वेश्चन पूछ सकता है जो है आपसे, हाउ मेनी कंपाउंड इज नॉट गोइंग टू डी कलराइज ब्रोमीन वाटर। तो हम लोग के पास सिंपल सा लॉजिक है, आइदर दैट शुड कंटेन डबल बॉन्ड, और ये फिनॉल और एनिलीन का केस हो सकता है, दैट्स ऑल। तो ये जो है आप प्रैक्टिस करो, इसमें सफिशियंट जो भी प्रॉब्लम्स दिए गए उसको प्रैक्टिस करो। अगर डाउट होता है तो योर डाउट इज ऑलरेडी जो है हमेशा वेलकम है उस डाउट के लिए, कोई अच्छे डाउट है तो बिल्कुल जो है अप्रिसिएबल है। तो आप जो है इसको पहले ट्राई करो खुद से, और फिर इफ देयर इज एनी डाउट, यू कैन गो फॉर द डाउट डिस्कशन।